Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is Hany Ismail from Planning Engineer website. Welcome to this session on reading a P6 time schedule, a key tool in project management. In this lesson, we will learn how to read a time schedule created in Primavera P6, an industry standard tool for project planning and scheduling. So let's go and see how to read a P6 time schedule. A time schedule is a tool used to plan and track work over the course of a project. It helps project manager ensure that the tasks are completed on time. It consists of activities, each with a start date and finish date and duration. For example, the construction of the ground floor, it will take 1 month. It will start in January and completed in February. However, using a table to represent a time schedule is a little bit confusing. In 1910, Henry Gantt, an American engineer, created a way to better visualize time schedule through what we now call the Gantt chart. The Gantt chart are essential in project management for visually tracking project timelines and task dependencies. Here is a simple version of a Gantt chart. Each row represents an activity, and the colored bars show the duration of each task over time. This visual tool makes it easier to track the project progress and identify any delays or overlaps between the tasks. For example, here the activity 1, I can see simply it will start in month 1 and complete it in month 2. Activity 2 will start from month 2 until month 4, and so on. So it is easy to understand how it is started. The concept of time scheduling has evolved significantly since Gantt invented. Today, sophisticated softwares like Primavera P6 help us managing complex schedules with great accuracy and efficiency. However, this was the start of the Gantt chart, and this is how time schedules are currently visualized in Primavera P6. It is more detailed and comprehensive than the traditional Gantt charts, allowing for more management of large and complex projects. Let's take a closer look at how to read and interact with a P6 time schedule. So this is a time schedule. It consists of two main parts. The table section in Primavera P6, the table section contains the important data about each activity, such as start, finish, duration, and percentage of works. We will go through them in a minute. Understanding this section is important because you cannot read the time schedule without knowing what is inside here. But for now, I need you to understand that this is the table section, which has data. And we have here the Gantt chart, which is providing a visual representation of the project timeline. Each bar represents an activity, which is the position also, and the length is matters. So the length of the bar chart will represent the duration, and the position of the bar chart will tell us when it should be start or it should be finished, or when it is actually started or actually finished. Also, we have here the time scale. The time scale located at the top of the Gantt chart, showing the project timeline broken into months, weeks, or days, depending on the project needs. The scale helps you to track when the activity are scheduled to start and finish. So if we take an example here, this activity should start by this date and should finish by this date. Let's see also what we have here, the WBS group of activity. WBS, or work breakdown structure, organize project activities into groups. Each group may represent a specific phase or a component of the project. It helps managing the project by breaking down complex tasks into manageable sections. And we can identify the WBS from the colors. So this WBS starts from this color until we have the same color is repeating again. So the civil works here, in this example, will continue until we have a same color, so it will stop. This is the activity inside the WBS, represented by a complete row. Each activity in P6 time schedule has a unique identifier. We call it here activity ID. which make it easy to reference and track specific tasks throughout the project. In P6, activities are the building blocks of the time schedule. So the component of the time schedule activities, then we group them into WBS. We start showing some information in the columns and the bar chart will be drawn automatically. We have also here activity name. The activity name describes the task that needs to be completed. For example, installing floors or pouring concrete, it is important to clearly define activities to ensure there are no confusion about what work needs to be done. Also, we have here the activity duration. The activity duration indicates how long the task will take to complete. The baseline date or plan date. You can see it, you might see it BL, project start. BL is for baseline, or you might see it as a planned start. The baseline start date is the date the activity is initially planned to start. It is part of the baseline schedule, which is used as a referencing point to tracking the progress. Any deviation from the baseline can indicate schedule slippage. Whenever you see BL, it means baseline, project start from its name, it will give us the start dates of the project if you are looking at the project level, or for the activity if we are looking in the activity level. Baseline finish date. The baseline finish date is the planned completion date for the activity, like the start date. It is part of the baseline used to track whether tasks are being completed on time. If the actual date differs from the baseline, it could indicate a delay. I would like to draw your attention for something here. When you look at the activity level, as we agreed this is the activity level, you look to the data here, it will represent the activity data. But if you look to the WBS level, then the data here will represent the WBS data. So if you'd like to know some information about the ground floor, you should go to the ground floor WBS to see what is the percentage and what is the dates and so on. If you'd like to see or know specific information for a specific activity, you should read the data from this row. Let's complete about the actual or forecast start. Here we can have the start, finish, and so on. Let's talk about the start. The actual or forecast start date reflects when the activity either started or is expected to start. If the task has already started, the actual start date is recorded. If the task hasn't started yet, the forecast start date will be shown. And I will tell you in a minute how to differentiate between the forecast start date and the actual start date. If the activity has started, there will be an A letter at the end of the date. Like here, this one, we find A. All of this mean it is actual start. However, these dates, no A letter, it means this is forecast date. Another way to understand it, I will tell you at the end of this presentation. So this activity is started on 3rd April 2024. How you know here the date? The start date is 3rd April 2024 and there is A letter at the end of the date, so I know it is already started. However, this activity is expected to start on 20th May 2024. Why I know it is expected? Because there is no A letter here. Same as actual start, we have here actual and forecast finish. This will show when the activity is expected to finish or if it is already finished. The actual completion date is recorded whenever it is completed. We can differentiate also if it is actual date or forecast date from the A letter. This activity already finished on 27 March. Why it is already finished? Because there is a letter at the end of the date. However, this activity is expected to finish on 8th June. This date without A, it is expected. So let's see also something here. If you can see here that this activity already completed before this line. I will tell you this line what it means in a minute, but whatever in the left of this line, it means done. Whatever in the right of this line, it means it should be done or a forecast. Planned percentage indicates how much of the activity should have been completed by a specific date. It is a useful metric to understand if the project is on track. For example, if 50% of a task was planned to be done, but today we only did 20%, this as a sign for a delay. The actual percentage, the same as we talked about planned percentage, it's showing the actual percentage of work done. Now let's talk about the line I was talking about before. This line represents the data date. The data date line is a vertical marker on the Gantt chart representing the current reporting date. It indicates where we are in the project timeline and help compare the planned and the actual progress. Tasks completed before the dates should have been actual start and finish date. And the dates after this line, it is forecast dates or still in the planned version. Started and finished on baseline date, as you can see here, this is an activity exactly started and finished as per the baseline. How did you know, Hany? I can see from here, this is the baseline start date 5 April, and the start date, the actual start date is 5 April. The baseline finish date is 20 April. The forecast finish date is 20 April. So simply from this one, I can say that this activity started and finished on time. From here also, I can see that this black line, this black horizontal line represent the baseline dates, and this one represents the actual dates. If you can see, the position of the line also matter. The position of this black line always in the blue line, and it represents the baseline dates. However, we have here in the above one, it has two colors. We can see this dark blue and the green. Dark blue, it means it is completed. Green, it is mean it is still in progress. So this example shows an activity that is started and finished on the planned dates, meaning it was completed exactly as scheduled. This is ideal scenario, indicates the project is progressing as planned. Let's take another example here. This activity is started after the planned dates and is still in progress after the planned finish date. How we can know? We can know from the table here, or we can know from the Gantt chart. From the Gantt chart, it is showing this activity started after the planned date, and it is not yet completed because it still has some green bars. Also, I can find out the information from the data here. This one planned to start 11 April, however, the actual is 16 April. It is planned to finish 30 April, however, the forecast is 19 May. Another example of an activity, this is a delayed activity, not started at all. It is should start in 1st May, as you can see here, this 1st May, same as here, 1st May. However, the start date is telling me 20 May, and it is still yet forecast, because there is no A after the date. So in this case, the activity has not started as planned, and is expected to start later than originally scheduled. It is being delayed by another activity that hasn't finished yet. Tracking these delays helps project manager to identify the bottlenecks and take corrective action. This was a very quick review of our lesson today, how to read a Primavera time schedule. Later on in the course, we'll go deeper and tell you how to open it in Primavera and how to make some different filters. Thank you for watching this lesson. I hope you find it useful. See you in the next one.